Hey everybody, it's Lavender Town.
And I'll be honest, even though I've been a character designer for a long time, I've never once tried to draw a fursona or really any anthro art at all, and I think that that's kind of weird, so today I'm going to take a crack at it from a character design perspective. First things first, I had to find a suitable animal that matched my personality, so of course I went to take about a million personality quizzes on the internet. I started with BuzzFeed, and almost all of the What Animal Are You quizzes centered around your favorite foods and the type of interior design that you happen to like, which I think is a really weird mixture of things, but this might not shock you guys, but all of these internet quizzes kind of let me down. The variety of animals that I got was just way too great, and there were almost no repeats. I got a couple for cat. But it didn't really seem to dig deep into my personality, which might make sense because it's a generalized BuzzFeed quiz half the time. I took a lot of quizzes. Here are just the results from the BuzzFeed ones since they all have pictures. And as you can see, there's almost no consensus here. So once I was done with that, I decided to actually take a crack at this from more of a character design perspective. A lot of the times when I'm designing a character seriously, what I do first is write down all the things I know about them, things that are really pertinent to who they are. And so I tried to do the same with my personality. It's kind of weird to look at yourself from the outside like that, but I was really trying to pick the perfect animal because I really wanted to get this right. And because I'd never really done any art of this type before, I was kind of nervous to mess it up. I knew one of the first things that I wanted to figure out is whether I would be a carnivorous animal or an herbivorous animal, and I landed on a more vegetarian type animal because I myself am primarily vegetarian, as well as I'm also very anxious. I feel like a lot of the carnivorous animals have a lot more confidence just because they are at the top of the food chain, whereas prey animals definitely have more of a jumpy, sort of like looking around at all times kind of personality, which unfortunately matches much more closely with my own. So I immediately started going down that path and started thinking about herbivore animals that might suit me. I noticed something interesting is that like a lot of the most popular animals that furries like to use for their fursonas are carnivorous, so immediately I was off to kind of an offbeat selection. I was tempted by the idea of a bunny, I think mostly because I was kind of inspired by Beastars for this entire video, as well as things like Zootopia. It seems like bunny female characters are actually pretty common. And the contrarian in me made me want to sort of lean away from that and do something a bit more uncommon. I started to think about the idea of like a deer. I really like that idea just because a lot of people base furries on some of their favorite animals, and I do love deer. I think that they're extremely like magical and awesome. I then started to think about goats, and while goats are not as elegant as deer, they definitely do have a lot of like charm and character to them, and there's a lot of things visually that go on with goats that could be super super fun and interesting to draw. And I also got to thinking about like the fact that goats eat paper and are known for eating things that they're not supposed to, but in particular things like paper, and it made me think that it would be really funny for an artist like myself to be a goat in a sort of like animal universe. So I got really attached to that idea from that point forward. I got really inspired for this idea from an artist named Nagabe. I actually don't know what their full real name is. They work under a pseudonym for their manga, which I love, called Girl from the Other Side. But I found out that they actually used to post a ton of different like anthro art, and it's like super elegant and very amazing. So I got really inspired, and they really like to draw horned animals, so they draw a lot of goats and deer and stuff like that. So that was really helpful when I was designing my character, because this is somebody who really excels at that. So it was a really good sort of inspiration for me. I ended up going with the goat primarily because there were so many interesting things that I could draw. Goats have a very unique type of eye shape in their pupil, and they also have these like wonderful ears and horns that just make for wonderful, really enjoyable things to like incorporate into the silhouette of your character. And truthfully, if I really went straight to my like personality and like little quirks about how I look, I probably would have gone with either a rabbit or a deer. The deer would have made a lot of sense because I have freckles, and fawns actually have white freckles, so that would have been perfect. And as for the bunny, it would have worked really well with like a lop bunny, because lop ears would work well as like my hair, as well as my teeth are actually kind of bunny-like. Like my front two teeth definitely are more prominent than all of my others, so that would have worked out really well. But I had to go with a goat. It just, the character designer in me really, really wanted to draw these like big loopy ears and these like fun horns on the top of my head and stuff like that, so I had to go for it. Plus, I thought the goat's diet was probably the most close to mine. Like, goats eat a lot of junk food that they're not really supposed to, and that's definitely true of me as well. So I definitely gave the goat some like boba, just to show that she's not eating vegetables like she's supposed to. She's eating a bunch of like junk food, and I thought that that would be sort of an endearing quirk for her, as well as really accurate to the subject of this character design. I realized after I finalized the sketches, but it turns out that most of this type of art doesn't actually put like hair on the characters in the traditional way. Usually they just try to make the fur work into sort of a hairstyle rather than just like plopping human hair on them. So this might have been a failure of mine, but I feel like if I ever did get really into drawing more anthro art, I would definitely still want to give them hair. I'm not sure why I'm still so hung up on it, but especially when it comes to drawing a character that's supposed to somehow resemble myself, I couldn't figure out a way to do it with just the short hair that a goat's head would have. It just didn't look like me, so I ended up giving the character like long pink hair like I have, so it kind of looks like a goat in a wig, but well, I'm learning at least. I feel like I really avoided doing any sort of anthropomorphic art, primarily because so many people on the internet as I was growing up really made furries the butt of the joke, or were like actually creeped out and afraid of them. But I started to realize that so many of the shows and movies and things, even games like Animal Crossing that I really enjoyed, had a type of anthropomorphic character in them somewhere. And I started to just realize how silly it is to avoid a whole sort of genre that's started in antiquity, just because it's like unpopular in a few communities on the internet. So I really got inspired to make this, and I really, really wanted to just give it a try because I've always loved animals, and I've loved drawing them when I was a kid. So I thought it's something I should get back into. I definitely need to study a lot of like anatomy and stuff when it comes to animals. It's very difficult because they all have wildly different bone structures and muscle structures and stuff like that, but it's something that I'm willing to learn because I think this can add to a character designer's like sort of visual toolkit. And honestly, it was just fun to do for a change. I mean, I've drawn so many humans lately. It's like, it's good to like break out of your comfort zone and try new things. So for the coloring, I definitely wanted to incorporate my own colors of my actual, you know, human self, because otherwise I feel it would be completely unrecognizable. I was tempted to use my natural hair color instead of the pink because I was honestly scared that it wouldn't work. I feel like this type of design would have worked best with natural colors, but I was actually pleasantly surprised that this sort of like neutral peachy color that I tried to match to my in-person hair right now actually suited the like browns and white colors of the goat design that I was doing pretty well, and it ended up being really, really cute. I do feel like in general, whenever I'm not sure about colors, I tend to just go over and over with it with like different multiply and overlay layers and lots of shading, and that can tend to make my work look a little less confident. This whole process, for some reason, I'm not sure why, but it really made me introspective about the choices I was making. I guess because I wasn't just sort of like falling into my natural sort of like character design repertoire. I wasn't drawing a like character design that I had done 100 times before. So it really got me thinking about like all of the choices I was making, and I actually realized at the end that I wished I'd kind of stopped at the flats rather than going into the shading. But I'll let you guys decide for yourself whether you agree with that or not. So for the first pose, I wanted to just do sort of the character standing facing forward, pretty neutral, nothing too dramatic because I wanted the design to really shine through. That's actually why I did like this sort of pseudo half-hearted turnaround, because I really wanted to make sure that you guys could see the character as I had envisioned her. So I basically just did two different hairstyles, two different outfits, both of which I actually have, and tried to incorporate the colors of the goat part of the character in with the colors of the clothes that I actually have and stuff like that, and I feel like they actually blended pretty well. I found a new brush that I absolutely love, by the way. I think it's called Glowy in Procreate. I highly recommend it for shading. It was really, really natural and nice. It felt like it was sort of blending itself, which is really, really cool. Here's where I started messing like crazy with all of the like shading layers. I just really wanted to see what would happen, and I wanted her to look sort of ethereal. One of the things that I think pushed me away from anthro artists when I was younger was I had this bad assumption about them that they all had horrible coloring. I really didn't like the neon colors and stuff, but of course later I realized there's tons of anthro artists that use all kinds of color palettes, and I was just being sort of biased. Here is how she turned out. I actually kind of love her. I am starting to feel like I've really missed out by not trying to put together animal and human characteristics in my characters before. It's definitely something I'm going to experiment with more in the future, and hopefully I'll get better at and stuff. I hope you guys enjoyed the video and watching me design this character, and I hope you guys are staying safe, not getting sick. I will see you in the next one. Thank you to all of my patrons, including Bald-Headed Potato, Bella Story, Best Kaiju, Braggy, Kompopon, Lion, Clockwork Construct, Joe, Dr. Casket, Alaria Louie, Greer the Animator, Griffix, Hachiyubi, Ice Cream Pal, Ivan Rodriguez, JJJ, Joseph Koppel, Marina Costa, Micah Dactyl, Mr. Dr. Pence, Nicolette Queen, Nora Cornielsen, Ruined Rain Crow, some mediocre artists, The Artsy Moose, Throat Foam, XAM, and your boy ST.